Guess it's been a while since you've been here. I mean, Las Serenas.
Not for years.
This casino, wasn't this the first piece of property you bought on the island?
Yeah.
Did you used to come here with her? I'm sorry, Robert, I just... trying to get my mind used to the two of you. After so many years...
Señor, the young lady you wish to see.
Luisa, you're all grown up. You do remember me, don't you? Can you guess why I'm here? Why?
For La Rubia, señor.
That's right. And you've seen her, haven't you? You don't need to be afraid. No one wants to hurt her. I'm the same as I always was. I just want to be with her.
Eden?
I'm here. The bleeding stopped. You're gonna be all right. Things are gonna be just the way they were. And I'll always be here for you. Always.
I thought you'd be here.
I was coming right back.
You could have left a note.
I'm sorry.
Good God, every word out of my mouth, you feel the need to apologize.
I don't mean to be difficult.
No wonder you're evading me.
I'm not. We're talking about a part of my life here. I have more of a claim to it than you do. And I feel like I'm living it for the very first time.
I hope you don't mean that.
Cruz, if there'd been no car accident, if I'd have remembered everything, I would have told you a long time ago. But I would have told you the same way you tell people that you love about people that you loved a long time ago. The way that you told me about Victoria and Santana. Not every detail, not every dinner, not every argument. That's not evading. That's thinking about the feelings of somebody that you love. The other things are private. And as it stands now, I feel like I'm experiencing everything at the same time as you are, and that's not fair to me. And it's not fair to you. I came here by myself because I needed a few moments to see if I could remember anything without you standing over me, insisting that you tell...
I don't need to be told every detail, believe me. In fact, I'm sure there's some things I'd rather not hear about. But the fact remains, Barr is holding something over you that you don't understand yet, Eden. And until you do, what's important to remember and what isn't is yet to be determined.
Robert was just very sick, and I was taking care of him. I don't know who shot him.
The man you remembered from the bar, the guy in the Panama hat, could it have been him? Could it have had to do with that hustle the two of you were running at the casino?
Maybe.
You say Robert was sick. How sick was he? Was he in the hospital?
I don't know. I was taking care of him here. He was very sick. He had been bleeding. He was bandaged. There was medication on the table. It was a prescription. I'm sure he was treated by a doctor.
Well, there is a clinic on the island. It might not be such a bad time to pay that place a visit, see if they have any records under the name of Parisi. You coming? She just woke up this morning with the most terrible stomach cramps, and I figured this is the kind of thing that happens to tourists all the time, but somebody who knows about it should probably take a look at her.
Well, your wife looks to be feeling better, are you, Senora?
A little.
Oh, that's so like her. You know, she never likes to complain, but I'm sure she'd rather prefer to have a doctor look at her, wouldn't you, dear?
Let me see what I can do. Excuse me.
It would help if you acted sick.
I thought you were going to be the patient.
Well, I was going to be the patient, but do you notice the files are all out here, you know? I'm going to look.
Senora?
Sister, I actually would feel a little bit more comfortable if there was a woman inside with me.
Oh, I understand. Come with me.
Parisi R. July 10, 1979, gunshot wound. September 3rd, 1979, records forwarded to San Sebastian Prison.
You lived here?
Yeah, I did.
It's hard to picture.
It is.
Robert?
I feel like I've been asleep for 30 days.
2.5 days. Don't move, don't move. If you have any pain, I have some medication.
2.5 days? You've been here that whole time?
Where else would I be?
What if they'd come back? What if they tried it again?
Pepe and Marty and Otto, they've been outside and they've been keeping watch every day. All you have to think about is getting well. And what you do, we're going to go away, just the two of us. Nobody can find us.
We've got to find them.
Well, maybe it's something I just sort of had for a day and my body's already recovered.
So, how does she seem to you, Doctor?
I can find no obvious problem based on examination.
The doctor would like to perform some laboratory tests tomorrow. You see, the lab is only open 2 days a week.
Great, well then I'll bring her back tomorrow.
Most incidents like this are not serious, but the few that are very serious indeed. I would like to keep Senora Reyes here tonight under observation, just in case.
No, I mean, I appreciate your concern, but really, I don't need to stay here. I'm feeling
this,
much better.
Just,
of course.
Just a moment. Let's talk about this, dear.
What are you trying to do to me?
Listen, Barr was in prison. Barr was in prison.
What?
Yeah, there's a file right there, but most of the contents have been forwarded to the district of prison. They were forwarded in September of 1979.
Well, what did he do?
You have no idea?
Of course I don't. I was in school by then in Europe.
Well, Eden, this could lead us to the thing he doesn't want us to know. the thing that could unravel his hold on the company, not to mention his hold on you. I've got to follow this up.
By hospitalizing me?
San Sebastian is the main island, right?
Yes.
Well, it's still early. If I can rent a skiff, I can be there and back by nightfall. And I don't think it would be any harm for you to stay here tonight. This looks safe here anyway. That's a good idea, isn't it? I thought you'd think so. You know, I think I've talked my wife into staying here. We'd rather be safe than sorry.
Very wise, senor. We will take good care of her.
Okay. I'll be back by nightfall. Okay? Okay?
Now, don't be sad. Our rooms upstairs are very nice. Nicer than the hotels, everyone says. I wouldn't know myself. Let me get you a nightgown and robe so you can lie down and rest if you like.
Thank you.
Is this your and Senor Reyes' first time on Las Sirenas?
Yeah.
Oh, you look very much like someone who used to live here years ago.
Somebody else said that.
Oh,
who is it?
I never knew her name. They called her La Rubia. You look very similar, but she was different even so.
Different how?
Oh, she a little wild. They said she was very wicked. Maybe she was, but then there are those who said I was very wicked when I was a child, too.
What did she do that was so wicked?
That was a long time ago. Let me see. No, you're too tall for this one. Ah, here we are. And a nice warm robe. It gets cool here at night. I'm sure you've noticed. Senora Reyes? Yes, that would be Senora and Senora Reyes. She did look very familiar.
How long ago did she leave?
An hour. The quickest way back to town, of course, is the beach.
Thank you.
Frank Castillo.
So, Senor Reyes, he left first?
Yes, he seemed very suspicious. He tried to look in the files. He seemed nice at first, but... Wait! You can't do that. They're
very
confidential. Please,
okay.
Senor.
I'm not going to take any...
Inspector, I think you understand that the prison records cannot be released or opened to anyone. Perhaps if the American consulate would request it. But otherwise, no. Personally, I'd be more than happy to help you with your investigation. But this is only my second year here, so if the prisoner is no longer with us, I may not be able to help you. What is his name?
I'm sorry, Warden, but I'm not allowed to reveal that.
I see. Well, we have a problem.
Would you object to me speaking directly with prisoners who've been here, say, 10 years ago?
No. But I can tell you from experience that it will do you no good. No matter what they may think of this person that you're investigating, they will not discuss so much as the weather with a police officer. Not even an American one.
Well, you know, I think we might be able to find a way around that one.
Uh-huh. Well, you look the part.
Good. All I'm going to need is a couple of hours. Can you give me that?
Well, it's much more than I would care to spend with my permanent residence. I can't be responsible for you.
Yeah, I understand that.
Escort the new prisoner to his assignment in cell block D.
Warden, I'd like to talk to you about that man. He's not who he says he is.
No, you can't carry a woman over the threshold unless you're married first.
Well, if you're not going to give me an answer, then that means I have the right to make up whatever I want, right?
Well, maybe if you propose to me properly, I will give you a proper answer.
Do that.
No. No. No, don't do this. Shh. Not this proper.
I love you, Eden. I know I'm never going to love anyone else as long as I live. I don't know if my life would have any meaning to me without you. I don't even know if I'd want to live it. I want you with me. I need to know that you will be with me. Anything less than forever will be enough. So please, say you love me, that you'll be my wife.
Yes, I love you. And I want to be your wife. Sit up off your knee. Oh, you make me so happy. When are we going to do it? When are we going to get married?
Tomorrow. No, no, no. Right now.